Sunglasses, like a brand new pair of jeans. I feel like taking chances. I feel a lot like 17. Oh, I feel like windows roll down, new cities, streets, and cabs. I feel like anything can happen. Laughing, you take me right back to when we were kids. I feel like this. Like when I close my eyes, don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. And I can fly, don't even think we're touching the ground, yeah. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way I feel when I'm with you. I'm brand new. Oh, 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 oh. Like when I close my eyes, don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. I can't fly, don't even think I'm touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way I feel when I'm with you. I'm brand new. Oh, 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 oh. I'm brand new. Oh, oh, brand new.
Hey, Res Life students, my name is Blake, and we are continuing our rhythm series. And today we're talking about Sabbath. Maybe you've heard that word before, maybe you haven't. It's a word we first find in the Old Testament. And Sabbath means to stop, to cease, or to keep, which later becomes known as a day of rest. We first get this idea of Sabbath in the creation story. You know, when God is creating the earth, the 7 days, and on the seventh day, we hear that God rested. That's in Genesis 2, 2 through 3. So here we understand that even God was intentional about resting. Hey, if I created the world in 7 days, I would probably want to rest too. But then later in the Old Testament, we hear about the Ten Commandments. And there's this another call to observe Sabbath and to rest. And it says, remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. You shall not do any work, you, your son or your daughter, your male or female slave, your livestock, or the alien resident in your towns. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, but rested on the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and consecrated it. And at this point in the story, God is distinguishing that no one should really work on this seventh day of the week. And that is what the Jewish people did. They didn't farm, they didn't work, you didn't have to be a slave. Even the livestock would rest. The animals would rest. They stopped. They ceased from what they were doing, and they were just present. Now stay with me for one more story. There is this one passage about Sabbath I want to share with you in the New Testament. Jesus enters the story and the people are still observing the Sabbath like they did in the Old Testament. And some religious leaders see Jesus picking some grain, probably to eat with him and his disciples. They might have been hungry. And these religious leaders are confused and wondering, why is Jesus working on the Sabbath? And this is what Jesus says to them. The Sabbath was made for humankind, and not humankind for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is Lord even on the Sabbath. That's what Mark says in 2:23-28. Jesus is saying that Sabbath, a time of rest, was made for humans, Humans were not created to serve a Sabbath. No. Sabbath is a gift God gives to humans to rest, to stop, to be. It is also a reminder that no matter what day it is, Jesus is still Lord and desiring to serve us. So we have this gift of Sabbath that God gives us. And friends, I'll be honest, Sabbath is one of the hardest things for Christians to figure out on how to do. And students, a reality is that your generation, Generation Z, is the busiest generation our world has ever seen. Students, you have more commitments and tasks and activities and responsibilities going on in your life than any other generation before you. And with that, you have to ask yourself the hard question, when am I going to rest and be with God? When am I going to intentionally take time and breaks from my tasks and responsibilities and accept this gift of Sabbath that God is handing to me? So what might Sabbath look like in your life? I'll admit, I a lot of times pull the busy card and say, I'm too busy for that, I'm too overwhelmed, there's just too much going on. But what happens when I do that is that I get worn out. I get physically and mentally exhausted. And when I go a long time without resting my body or my mind, and I don't remember all that God is doing in my life, I get worn out. And I'll admit, I will binge watch a season of The Mandalorian and sit on my couch for hours. I admit, I did that over Christmas break, but I'm not sure that's the type of Sabbath that God wants us to have. When I was in college, I really tried to take this idea of Sabbath seriously. But I knew that I wasn't going to be able to do a full 24 hours of Sabbath like they talk about in the Old Testament. So I asked myself a question. Where is a moment in my week when I can have a Sabbath, a mini Sabbath, where I can turn off my phone, not think about my homework, and just open up my Bible and be? And I looked at my schedule and I realized the only time I had free was on Fridays from 12 to 4 o'clock p.m. So my entire junior year of college, every single Friday from 12 to 4 o'clock p.m., I would put my phone on silent or put it in my backpack, and I would walk to maybe a coffee shop or I would just read my Bible or I would journal and I would take my Sabbath. Sometimes I would go on a long walk in the neighborhood. Sometimes I would just pray. Sometimes I would just listen to worship music in silence. Sometimes I invited pastors that I knew just to have a conversation. And what I quickly found by committing to this every single Friday is that I had a second to pause, to cease and to stop, to remove distractions in my life and be present with God. I found a way to do Sabbath, to rest my heart, to rest my body and receive that moment of rest that God was handing me and is always handing me. I once read about a person who said that they thought Sabbath was just for retired people who really weren't busy, and how this person felt they didn't need a Sabbath. And friends, I'll admit, I've said that too. We all need a Sabbath, regardless of our age or occupation or list of responsibilities or whatever environment we live in. Sabbath is a time to remember that God is in control and can do the work for us. We don't have to do it on our own. And one of my favorite authors, Ruth Haley Barton, says, "The point of Sabbath is to honor our need for the sane rhythm of work and rest." I love that phrase, sane rhythm. A reality is that so many of us live our lives at such a busy rhythm when we're going from school to practice to church to hanging out with friends to homework, college applications, another practice. That doesn't seem sane, it seems busy. Maybe you have felt like your schedule is insane or have been completely overwhelmed by it. Maybe this year we feel the opposite. And because of COVID-19, we've been home so much more, spending more time on screens and video games, scrolling on our phones or watching Netflix. It's hard to remember how to stop and just be with God, to allow our hearts to see God's presence, to remove distractions that are in our face. I'm not telling you to give up Netflix this year. I'm inviting you to notice everything else that is going on around you. And taking a Sabbath allows you to slow down your normal rhythm of life and refocus your attention on God. So friends, may we embrace that invitation that God hands us to be given a Sabbath. May we rest and notice God in all moments, to stop, to cease, and to be.